Hey guys, we're back doing another video. Today we're going to be doing a bob. And since everybody is doing pride hair, I'm going to get in on the trend. Green, go, blue, anyway, yellow, orange, and red. And we're doing an invisible part. So I'm going to track together, mark my cap, spritz it already. So let's get it. And today we're going to be doing an invisible part instead of an illusion part, because I haven't done an invisible part wig yet with this cap, so I'm trying that. And of course, you guys have to remember your first track is always your guide. So once you bun that first track, well, you can follow the guide of the lines. If you didn't have lines, you always remember that your first track is your guide. You can do two fingers between the next one or one. Or a little over one if you're doing it on someone's head, just to make it fuller. But this is a wig, so it's gonna be full anyway. So
no internet connection is needed to remotely grant access. Lockley's offline access code feature allows access codes to be sent remotely and grant access even in the most disconnected areas where internet or cellular connection is unavailable. You can also use Alexa and Google Assistant to lock and unlock your door.
And you
finally, you can always just use the key. Visit Lockley's website for more information behind their technology and features. We have a link below in our description.
It's the internet over there and it's on my purse.
They got over there?
They over there. It's Gushers in that thing, too.
It ain't no Gushers, though.
That box. It ain't no box.
Hey, this is
my purse. Yeah.
You got a big bag of them, man.
I got a big bag and the box.
Oh, yeah.
They might, I must have put them all up there and it's that candy.
Like a sofa set and like a
dining
table.
Yeah, we can overshot on the deck. I don't actually think we gave our crews exact
dimensions. Which one you said?
Huh?
Which one you really like?
Purple.
You haven't seen it yet. I
want to
see what you think.
You can have some, though. You, and it's strawberries in it's strawberry in the bag. Strawberry, green, and green apple, and blue.
No, there's no more mosquito bar fans.
There's also a toilet. They're just waiting for that to be put in. Something bad.
So things are coming along. We got trained up for our new island here. We're going to have a countertop coming out. Flooring is in. It's just waiting to get texture and paint on the wall so we don't mess up the floors.
Yeah, we approved the cabinet design plan yesterday. So that's coming soon.
So we just need these countertops.
That's
glass. I got 2 hours first.
Mm-hmm.
You guys are always asking us, where do we get over here?
We're at Pacific Shore Stones, our favorite vendor for countertops.
You ain't no Gushers in my
place?
Yeah,
over
there?
Is it shooting?
Okay.
Hey,
I'm going to do an illusion part, and I'm going to do my pieces bigger than I usually do if I'm doing on somebody's head, because I find that it's much easier, and even though my parts be flat, I want it to be extremely flat.
I think it looks sharp, honestly.
And this is a quartz. It's polished,
right?
Once you see it, it has the light. Okay.
So I really like this, but I think we should have maybe another option. Let's keep looking.
Let's, we just got here. There's so many stones to choose from.
Now I think about this one.
That was a solid choice. That was a big seller
for us.
Will we be able to hang them
up side by side? So this one seems to have like little more little imperfections, or I don't even know, pigments. So really, it just comes down to taste on these two.
Yeah,
absolutely.
And I think for the project we're doing and the location where it's at, I think it makes sense to go with the economic choice.
You think that's our winner?
Stone, but I think this is the winner for this project. We got more projects.
Look at you save the money.
I can on occasion.
All right, wrap it up. We'll take it.
Nathan, it was great. You guys have a great selection, as always.
Yeah.
Just all the knowledge. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks a lot. We appreciate you guys' business. With that being said, anybody that follows the Flipsters on YouTube or Instagram, mention us nationwide and get 10% off any of your materials.
Oh, that'd be awesome. Yeah.
Hope
you guys
love Flipsters. So a bit of a setback. Mm-hmm. You've got cabinets in. They're looking pretty good. A few adjustments to make, but
these were supposed to be
white.
So we were going to have white cabinets and gray counters, and now looks like we're going to be back to the white countertop.
So yeah, they
said, not our fault, people.
This is what really happens when flipping houses. They send you the ramp with the wrong cabinets, and you have to decide, is it worth sending these back and waiting like 3 to 4 weeks for the right ones to get in, or do we just call an audible and roll with it and make it work?
Yep, so we are going to option two. And our friends at Pacific Shore Stone were so great about switching it out last minute. They said no problem. They actually hand selected this left for us. They left us a little note.
How cute is that?
How cute.
Is that supposed to be you or me? plenty of setbacks at this house. Come with me, I'm going to show you guys this. This is crazy. Okay, so we came back to the job site the other day and found this.
Okay, so now I'm going to start adding my color. And my first color I'm going to go with is yellow.
And there's only so much that you can do about it. We've got security cameras, you can put up events, but at the end of the day, unfortunately, it happened. So we're about to wrap on the snail house. We just put in this brand new condensing unit. We put in all new HVAC, that's the air conditioning and the heating for the house. So it's going to be all brand new. And the other thing I wanted to show you is that broken window is finally fixed. The countertops are in, they're looking amazing. And really all we got to do is stage this thing in, and then it's going to be ready to go. So I just wanted to show you those couple things. New window. I also just want to take a quick minute and thank you guys. We just passed 33,000 subscribers. And we've been doing this like a little over a year, just sharing with you guys our journey on these before and after house flips.
Orange.
And we've had such a blast. We love hearing from you guys, and we love all the feedback and comments. One quick favorite to ask, we've had so many people reach out asking about like more detailed information about the process of flipping houses and how they get started, which is awesome. Yeah. A huge favor. We put a survey down in the description.
Yeah,
no guys that
ain't
interested at all.
You want it, man.
The process of flipping houses, how you get started, or even if you have no
idea. I just grabbed them and put them in my purse. That was for them.
That's what that survey is all about.
But I had Gay Enoch giving them cheers.
Me and my boy alone, bro. Yep.
Little dirty T. T. T.
D. 3.
Period.
Text message.
Red.
Here we are. Let's go from the top. We fixed it up this time. Instead of white with gray trim, and with gray with white trim. Mind blown, but I think it turned out very super cute. Let's go in. Looks so good. It really does. This is like a homie little home.
It looks good, homie.
Mm-hmm.
You remember the nasty carpet?
Mm-hmm.
And now we got a nice modern.
I think they're beautiful, honestly.
My rule of thumb in Austin is if I'm listing a house under $300,000, I usually put laminate in it. Over that, I usually put hardwood. This living space, though, is wide open.
My house today, I'm looking for is still that open concept where your living room and your kitchen are all wide in space. And by taking out that wall, we made this house come from 1979 to 2019. I'm so glad we took that wall down between the kitchen. I think it really makes this super functional. And we're concerned about the dining space because we took this symmetry all the way to that wall, which I think we needed to do for storage and functionality. But we had to kind of move the breakfast space. Originally, the door was right here. We moved it down closer to the living space. That way, we could create a breakfast nook area. We did a little bit off center on this light.
Okay, so let me finish this off camera, and then I'll be back when I'm doing the illusion part. Okay, you guys, so we are back. I did the first side already. It's an illusion. So now I'm going to do the second side with you guys on video. So let's hold the mannequin head down. So I cut them into this size. It's easier to cut them in bigger sizes. That way you can get it as flat as possible without overlapping it on the track. Like, this is how I'm showing you guys, but I will do it different. I mean, it depends on how I'm doing it, because with this one, it's not as much of the color here. So I had to cut them big and kind of space them out. And even though it's spaced out, it's still going to look very, very good. Because I know how to manipulate everything when it comes to hair. So we did the yellow. Now we're going to do the orange.
It's pouring in here, makes it feel like you're not trapped in a 1970s dungeon. And you've got your perfect cat tree over here.
I know.
Can you imagine little kitties scurrying up and down this thing?
Of course, we have a little cat statue.
So see, I'm doing just like that. Trying to close that middle part in a little bit more. But believe me, when I'm done, it's gonna be very nice.
Yeah, we could have done like shiplap or maybe like a new set of tile or something, but you know I'm all about saving that money.
I know, you're all about saving that money.
Leave a comment what you think we should have done if we hadn't just painted this rock. Do you like shiplap? Do you like tile? Do you like some other kind of stone? Rock actually used to go all the way.
And usually just cut them bigger so we can reach the track. I mean, it can reach the track, or you could have closed it in a little bit more so it can reach more towards the middle and not the part as, make the part as wide. But again, I know how to handle that, so I'll get that together once I'm done spraying everything right and spraying my spray. I'll get everything the way it needs to be, believe me.
Yeah, remember we had those old nasty cabinets in here that completely just,
yes,
they gone.
They gone.
So we're on to red, and we're just gonna repeat that same step all the way until we get to the green. And I tried to go from lightest color to darkest color, and I think I pretty much achieved that. Now we're going with blue.
Dude, looks awesome in here.
Yes.
Cute little bed.
Did you hear? The Pantone color of 2019 is coral.
What?
Nailed it. When I saw that Catalina chosen coral for the staging, I was like, that's my girl. Yeah, we are on trend. We are bringing in the new year with the color. Yeah, 2019.
You did that on purpose.
Yeah, it's the color of the year. 2019. Here we are.
What
future is now.
What was the color of 2018?
It was like a violet color. We weren't,
violet.
Coral is here today.
I'm sorry, Violet. You know I love you. I did not mean that. But Coral's my new bae.
Coral, we were so concerned about this awkward bedroom back transition, but with the staging, it really minimizes it, I think.
Yeah, so the only thing we did is, like, we closed off the top, so it didn't feel
so massively connected.
Yeah, it was
like a barn silo in there previously.
It was.
Yeah. In our wet spaces, we did the same tile patterns that we had in the guest bath.
So you may have noticed one thing missing from the shower, and it's the glass. Sometimes on a higher end flip, we definitely put that nice frameless glass. It's all about the price point that we're trying to hit. This is not the highest price point, and one of the areas you can save is just cutting that out because it's expensive, and your buyers don't necessarily demand it at those lower price points. Do you guys think this looks weird, or is it totally fine? Let me know in the comments.
We are loving these faux marble floors. They are so real. Awesome.
Lauren's pun game on fire! This house is certified dope as hell, Lauren.
Where do you get that certification anyway? The internet? Comment below if you think this house is dope as hell.
Do you give it 5 stars, certified dope as hell?
What will your Yelp review be of this house? Is Garfield gonna buy this place, or what? We designed it with him in mind.
Yeah, this is gonna cost more than a few
lasagnas.
Yeah.
He wants to be a lasagna. Is that cool? How many lasagnas do we have to give us for this house?
Mm-hmm. Well, I want to run the
numbers. So
35,000 lasagnas, right?
See the like
difference. $10
great. That's great.
That's a fair price to pay for some lasagna.
That's a lot for the rest of your life. Okay, so but seriously, when you get this thing on the market, what's the market looking like? What are we looking for?
I'm thinking you list this thing for $3.
So I'm just going ahead and pressing it down to make it flat.
Okay, so we bought this house for $230,000. Our all-in renovation costs were $67,000.
I'm going to take the yellow tool and move them up towards the part a little closer because I feel like it's a little too separated for me.
After about 3 weeks on market, we cut our price and accepted an offer for $355,000. So after $14,500 in closing costs, we had a net profit of $43,500.
Well, let's wrap, Cluster. We'll catch you on the next one.
Thanks. Hey, wait, check this out, though. Can crusher
No, you're good on your game. Maybe we ain't got nothing to do tomorrow.
Damn, Lord, you're
crushing it. Oh. I'm just combing it out so I can flatten it more. I combed one out, but I'm gonna put it back in. And keep in mind, make sure you make sure when you're doing this, you make sure that your part is dry. The glue is dry on the parts. That way, where they won't slip up. I'm gonna put another piece there also.
And you get a flipped house.
All right.
just gonna be a low. I'm gonna have to get another yellow piece. And right now, I don't have a yellow piece. I don't feel like looking for it, but I have one, and I'll get it later.
Alright, the facade is a little flat. We need to, yeah, we either need to pop a paint or something to spice up that brick.
Mm-hmm.
Thoughts?
I think white brick.
So I'm getting my flat iron ready. Cool. Jessica, go ahead and heat this before I
start plunging. Lots to come in, you know, third or fourth in line, because that means that there's a printed market.
This is a 3-bed, 2-bath, 1,335 square foot house. We bought it for $230,000. Demo has already started. We're
gonna using a Warren curl.
Okay, this is kind of a quirky little door frame.
To get that back. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take these back up. And I'm going to put them closer, and then I'm just going to add another orange piece. That way, this can be full as I want it to be.
When I first walked in, the unmistakable thing is those super high ceilings were amazing.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, I think we're definitely going to need to do something to dress this up. We can even take this out to make it not so massive and make it actually
bigger. I'm going to move the orange down a little bit more and get a red.
Now, I don't know if you felt this, but we got a little slope running.
Pull those up. Because I definitely want it to be right. I don't want it to be sloppy.
In Wilmington, North Carolina, and the news just went by like this. This is about as nasty as it's been. It's blowing by pieces of limbs. Yeah, we're joking about the slope in there, but the bill for the foundation repair, I know, is going to be no joke.
Looks like we've already torn out the kitchen.
Yeah.
It's all new cabinetry. I love that.
This leaves it open for us to reconfigure however we want.
I always like a sneak in front of the windows.
I think the old cabinets, you know, they came out to here, but it wouldn't hurt if we could maybe extend it another, I don't know, 6 inches or more. So.
Are you thinking to an L?
Yeah, we could do an L.
So now I got it the way I want it. I have no idea what I did with my good phone, but whatever.
Enormous for this size. So I'm super excited to see the size of the master of this house. I think that's going to be a selling feature because houses this size usually don't have a large master closet.
We have a super tight master space with a floating vanity, built-in storage wall.
Okay, you guys, I'm back. So this is the finished part and everything with the hair. So I'm going to cut it, and I'm not going to do a blunt cut. I'm going to do an asymmetrical cut. Using my razor comb, we're gonna start like this. I hate this stand. Anyways, let's start like this. So I cut it down some. I'm just gonna cut it as if I would cut a regular bob. You know, when you see me do a regular bob. I wish I could move the camera, but whatever. Life. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. We're going to start here and go up.
George, the drive, back out, Batum.
second, y'all, because I hate this mannequin head. I gotta get a better stand. So this one is so aggravating. It's so aggravating doing this on this head right here. It's so moving. You guys can't even see, so I'm gonna just stop the video. Okay, so I ended up cutting it in a blunt kind of, because the other cut wasn't really working for me, and I gotta cut that side a little bit shorter because this is longer than this side. So let me do that. Okay, so bomb. So let's start flat ironing. Hold on, y'all. They wear it?
Welcome back to the channel.
What did they say? They were good. What's good? I know y'all can't see me flat ironing, I'm sorry.
Wow. Okay. The house definitely has good bones.
So the finished look I will upload. I know you guys didn't see me flat ironing it, and I apologize, but this mannequin is horrible and it does not participate, so I just try to do what I can on video. But pretty much this is the look. So far, see you guys with the finishing look. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, comment, click the notification bell, everything.